everybody. We want to welcome you to the 49th Big Lakes Bud Fest Festival. And the opening banner this year is being carried by Marlis Oliver and Nyla, the daughters of Natalie Bender, who organizes this wonderful parade. And your hosts for this, I'm Rayanne Danielowski, Sherburne County Commissioner, serving District 2, Big Lake City, and Big Lake Township.
My name is Corey Scott. I am your Recreation and Communication Coordinator with the City of Big Lake.
Also, I want to say that we are honored to have the family of Don Orrock as our Grand Marshals this year. Don Orrock has been a longtime community volunteer serving on. He was appointed in 1988 to the Planning Commission and continuing with his 1994 appointment to the City Council. Don held that position until he was elected as our mayor in 1999. He had a great passion for serving the Big Lake community throughout his 15 years on the City Council, and he retired from his mayor's seat in 2008, but he remained a vibrant force in the community through his service with the Big Lake Lions Cub and the Big Lakes Blood Fest. During Don's tenure as mayor, he contributed considerable time and effort to numerous growth and expansion in the Big Lake community. So Don also played an instrumental role in numerous road improvement projects. And also you can thank him for the beautiful sidewalk esplanade that goes around our lake. The next time you walk along this beautiful area, please say thank you to Don for his dedication in getting this project funded and completed for all of your enjoyment for the generations to come. And we want to thank his family.
He was an absolutely vital part of Spudfest happening, and
yes,
we miss him very much.
We do miss him a lot.
So as you can see right now, we've got K-9 Bruno with the Big Lake Police Department. The Big Lake Police Department is a full-service law enforcement agency comprised of 14 full-time sworn police officers, K-9 Police Officer Bruno, as you saw earlier, and two administrative staff. They pride themselves with Big Lake's designation as one of Minnesota's safest communities.
And we also want to welcome our new police chief, Matt Hain.
Congrats to Matt Hain. This is a new position for him, and he's going to do just wonderful.
Yes, he will. He'll serve us well. And now we see the Big Lake American Legion Color Guard, post 147. And we would like to let everyone know that our POWs, our MIAs, are never forgotten. Riding with the Big Lake American Legion post is Steve Piccala.
There's that POW MIA vehicle.
Oh, and look at, they must have got this one out of retirement. That's an oldie. Thank you, guys, and thank you for your service.
Now we have the Big Lake Fire Department coming up right behind them. The Big Lake Fire Department is made up of 34 dedicated firefighters proudly serving the people of Big Lake Township, and Orrock. The department was established in 1909. We got some kiddos on that truck there. Thank you to the firefighters. It's a volunteer force.
Yep, they're a paid on call, and they definitely like to make noise in the parades.
They sure do.
And we want to thank them for their dedication and service to our community. I think they got every piece of equipment out here, too.
I think you're right. If anything happens, they're ready to go.
Yes. We try not to talk when they're making noise.
as you can hear.
Yeah. This is our newest piece of equipment, our new water carrier. These guys could not serve our community without the help and backing of their family as well. So we thank all the family members of the fire department.
They just keep coming.
They do.
Coming.
I think the ladder truck might be their last piece of equipment. Maybe.
We're going to find out.
Yeah.
Looks like we have some royalty.
Yeah, we do. The fire department has sponsored Jessica Osowski. Little Miss Candidate. Good luck, Jessica. Got her parade way down. Looks like the Monticello ladder truck snuck in here with their royalty. Thank you for coming over and crossing the river to participate in our parade and participate in our ceremony for our Big Lake Ambassador coronation.
Absolutely. A lot of collaboration between Monticello and
yes,
Big Lake.
Yes, there is. And here we have our Grand Marshals, the family of Don Orock.
It's like they're having a great time.
Yep. We want to thank them for sharing their dad with us for all those years. That's his son, Nick, and Jamie. And that's probably the granddaughters in the backs. Oh, I see Liz is there, too. That's Nick's wife. And like I said, it was hard this year planning Spudfest without Donnie. We lost him to cancer. And we just, every time we had something to do, it's like, okay, Donnie did that. What do we do now?
Yeah, every meeting we'd find a new thing that he just took care of, no questions asked.
Yep. But he left us some pretty good notes and stuff, so we made it.
Absolutely.
But we know he's watching us.
Now we have the Sherburn County Sheriff's Office. It's led by Sheriff Joel Brott, the Chief Law Enforcement Officer for the county. Representing the Sheriff's Office today are Sheriff Joel Brott and Chief Deputy Steve Doran. Many different vehicles are used by deputies while in the line of duty, including boat and watercraft equipment, along with a patrol squad. Their volunteer reserves and mounted patrol deputies also assist the office with various support services in the course of their duties in the community. Please remember to buckle up every time and drive safely.
And we do also want to thank Sherburn County. They are great partners that work with our law enforcement agency as well, and they serve our county extremely professionally.
So there's that watercraft.
Yep, there it is. That's one of the reserve officers.
And there's the mounted patrol back behind that watercraft as well.
And there's Sheriff Brott handing out candy along the side. And now we have the mounted Sherburn County Sheriff's Patrol. This is a great group of people that dedicate their time to taking care of these horses and being available and ready for whenever they're needed.
Provides a lot of flexibility and and where they can be.
Yep.
Versus a traditional vehicle.
And everybody loves to see the horses in a parade.
Very true.
Usually always followed with someone who's walking behind with the scooper.
It's a very important job.
It is. Nobody coming behind those horses.
A lot of candy being thrown in those streets.
Look how pretty they are. I just love to watch horses.
Beautiful. Oh. They've got a nice cool day today,
yep.
Which is good for the horses.
And the Scoop Patrol gets to have a four-wheeler to do their job.
They're streamlining.
Oh, we got some ones that are getting a little skittish
with the
noise.
Little wily.
She's handling them well, though.
You can tell they've worked together before.
Yep, he's a strutting his stuff. Oop, he's got to get out and do his job.
Thank you to that officer for taking care of that for us.
He's the one that does it every year.
That is a beautiful wave. He's practiced that one before.
Yes, he has. He's got some parade experience. Next, we have Rock On Trucks. They're proud to display their Pink Panther Diabetes Awareness Truck. This is one of many awareness trucks they have on their fleet. As the trucks say, you never know how strong you are until being strong is the only choice you have. To learn more about Rock On,
you can visit their website.
Yep, go to their website, rockon.com. That is cool that they do that. That's a nice looking truck.
And here we have the 2020-2021 Big Lake Ambassadors. The Big Lake Ambassador Scholarship Program provides opportunities for young women of our community to earn valuable life skills, leadership qualities, earn scholarships. We're very grateful to Rose, Allie, Kaylee, Isioma, Ella and Calissa for their service and dedication.
And they served 2 years.
Yeah, I was going to say they had an interesting year with COVID, and they took it on. And
they did.
Extended
they did.
Their reign.
Yep, they did an excellent
grace.
Job. That was a lot of volunteering and a lot of, there weren't many parades last year because of COVID, of course, but there was a lot of volunteer opportunities. So they served our community very well. The Big Lake Ambassador Program is just one of those amazing programs that is so fun to watch these young ladies when they do get crowned and they start their year and what they develop into over that year. And you know, Corey, you were a Big Lake Ambassador. Tell us what year you were serving.
Yes, 2009, 2010. And I'm very grateful to have the opportunity to MC the coronation that's happening right after the parade today.
Awesome. Yep. And I get to be one of the judges. And like I said, it's just amazing to watch these young women and what they develop into in their poise, their confidence. It's just really a cool thing to see. It looks like we have a gap in the parade. Not
that
quite
can happen
sure
from
why.
Time to time.
Yep.
Oh. But here comes the Wave Youth Center.
Yep, the Wave Youth Center, fun activities and a place to be all summer as well as during the school year. Middle school and high school students are welcome. And the Wave is over in the building on Lake Street across from City Hall. And they do an amazing job on providing a place for kids to go, be able to work with each other, lots of different activities, and just a place where they can just be accepted and be kids. And so we appreciate the Wave Youth Center for They kind of started, and then COVID hit, so they were shut down for a while, but they're back up now, and just cannot appreciate them more for being in the community and offering these opportunities for our young people to have a safe place to go.
Absolutely. There's a lot of opportunities to support them as well through fundraising and attending their events. Oh, look at.
Yeah. And they are a nonprofit, so they do basically rely on a lot of donations and contributions from the community or volunteering. They're always looking for people to volunteer their time. If you have something you can share that a young person would benefit from, they welcome everybody to come and participate. We always believe in our community that it takes a village to raise our young people, and we strive to do that the best that we can.
I do believe they have a golf tournament coming up as well. If you're interested in participating in that, you can find information on their website.
Yep, check that out. Fun way to help support them.
Next, we have the Big Lake Baseball Association. They have been in existence since 1986. They've been serving the youth in the community ever since. Their vision is reaching and developing youth through teamwork, sportsmanship, rules of the game, and character building lessons.
And I'm sure they're just as excited to be out playing ball after a year off of COVID, getting back to what normal looks like these days.
Absolutely.
Yeah, good to see them out. Followed by their coach. I think that's Mr. Hastrika. All right, next up we have the Big Lake Youth Lacrosse Team. They're a growing sport in Big Lake. It's a fun sport for active boys and girls to participate in. So if you're interested in trying lacrosse, contact the school and get your kids involved. Looks like they have a good time.
All kinds of candy.
Yep.
It's like they're handing them out to the Cable Commission. Much
Thank
deserved.
You. Yes, they are. They're not forgetting us. Thanks, guys. Okay. Next up, we have Kathleen Haney, our Sherburne County Attorney. She has proudly served us as your Sherburne County Attorney since 2003, and she extends her appreciation to everyone who made Spud Fest possible.
Now we have Bob's Towing. They're a sponsor of Big Lake Ambassador candidate Emily Lemire. They've been providing 24-hour emergency road service and towing to Big Lake and surrounding communities for 15 years. Fast and friendly service always is their motto.
And they definitely, in that 15 years, have grown. I can remember they started out with one truck, and then pretty soon over time, it's just expanded. They're a great family-run operation, longtime community members in the city.
They have tons of trucks in the parade today.
Yes, they can service all your needs. Flatbeds. And the horns work.
They sure do.
Plus, Nick's Towing has done an awesome job at times. Unfortunately, in the wintertime, there's people that think they can get through the channel between Big Lake and Mitchell Lake. Not usually a good idea. And Nick has been out there to have to basically get them out of when they fell through. Thank goodness nobody has been seriously injured through that process. So just a reminder, stay off the channel in the wintertime.
Absolutely.
And there's the owner, Nick, in the last big rig. All right, Next, we have Visions, proudly providing student transportation for the Big Lake, Elk River, Zimmerman, and Rogers communities. They are currently hiring bus drivers, and paid training is provided. And that is super needed. They've had a lot of, well, with everything in the workforce these days, they just can't find enough help. And it's important to get those kids to school.
Absolutely. There's a lot of job opportunities there. Keep in mind that paid training is available, and it's a very flexible position.
It is a flexible position. I was a bus driver for about 10 years when my kids were in school, and it was very helpful because you followed their schedule as well. When school was off and they were home, so was I. So, yeah, I always, and then you just can make a difference in young people's lives when you get to greet them in the morning and tell them to have a great day and greet them afterwards and hear how their day went. So,
a lot of young people out here today
enjoying the parade, waiting for the candy to get thrown. It's a great day, too. The breeze is awesome.
Little break from this intense heat that we've been having.
Yep, and it looks like we still have some more of the buses coming. They look like they got a little...
You can see their stop sign arm is up, so yep. Nobody can pass.
Yep.
Reminder to keep an eye out when buses are driving down the streets and stopping to let kids out.
Yeah, nobody should never be in as big a hurry that they're going to risk a young person just trying to get home safely. Or get
oh, look
to
at
school.
This. This is fun.
Isn't that cute? Super cute. Yeah, no, never, when you're around a bus, please always be cautious. It's better to be safe than sorry. If in doubt, stop. That's the best advice I can give. And never pass a bus on the right or the left.
Looks like behind Vision is the Minneapolis Aquatennial Ambassadors. Minneapolis Aquatennial will be celebrating its 82nd year. Festival founders selected the third week in July because this week has the best weather on record for the year. And the Aquatennial Ambassador organization exists to inspire young Minnesota women to achieve extraordinary futures by providing professional development opportunities through networking and mentoring. The ambassadors travel throughout the state of Minnesota, including being here today in Big Lake. They even travel across the country. The organization also provides educational scholarships to their ambassadors to help them reach their goals. The 2020-2021 crew is thrilled to be celebrating in Big Lake today.
Yep, and they are, they're always up here helping to support our ambassador program. So it's a really good partnership. So we want to thank them for coming out and being involved. There they are waving at us. They got a nice red, sporty looking convertible. All right, and then we also have the Minneapolis Aquatennial Senior Alumni Association. Representing the Minneapolis Aquatennial Senior Alumni are 2021 Senior Reigning Ambassadors Dale Borgensen, Commodore, and Queen Karen Holtmeyer. The Minneapolis Aquatennial Senior Alumni Association is an all-volunteer group that hosts and staffs community events for seniors during the Minneapolis Aquatennial. Uh-oh, I hear motorcycles.
And right behind the Aquatennial Senior Alumni is Zura Cycle Corps.
And we do thank them for coming every year. They put on a great show for us. Their skills are amazing on them motorcycles, how coordinated they can be when they're doing their maneuvers.
Looks like we see some Spudfest staff. Yep. Sneaking in front of the camera.
They want to make sure they push the crowd back so they give the motorcycles enough room to be able to maneuver and show us their skills. And here they go.
We're winding up.
Yep. We're going to probably not talk while they're doing this because their motors tend to get a little bit loud. But it is amazing. These guys just spend a lot of time and energy. This is a passion for them. And serving the Zura Shriners. They have a lot of different, this is just one part of what they do. They have the motorcycle corps, and they also have the little boats that do parades and stuff. Just a bunch of little good time activities that they can get involved in.
And their drill team is performing all over the Midwest for the benefit of the region's children's hospitals and clinics. Their motto is, "We ride so children can walk."
Yes, and we do appreciate that because they do a lot of great things for children. The Shriners Hospital and such, you can get treated there and it doesn't cost you anything.
Here they come. Trike there, three-wheeler.
Right. Sometimes when you get a little bit older, those are good.
Don't have to worry about dropping it and having to pick it back up.
You can tell they must practice this quite a bit.
Yeah, it'll make you dizzy, that's
for sure.
It
takes a lot of precision. You definitely have to trust the other person.
You can tell they've practiced quite a bit together.
Yes. They do this, I think, pretty much every weekend there's a parade that they're doing.
And they're all coming back this year,
yep.
So I'm sure they'll be quite busy.
Now
festival seasons
their,
have
yep.
kicked off.
They do their lineup formation now. Audience has given them a great round of applause for that great expedition that they did.
This must be where the breaks in the parade come from.
Yes. Takes a little while to do a performance.
And they can go a lot faster than some of the other vehicles.
Yes.
And people walk in with the candy.
Very true. I walked this parade route one time.
It's a lot longer than you think.
It is. Definitely is. And you need more candy than you think. All right. Next up, we have our Big Lake Little Miss Ambassador candidate, Melanie Spooden. She is sponsored by Anderson Tax Service of Big Lake. And Little Miss Ambassador candidate Melanie Spooden, we wish you a lot of luck and thank you for coming out and participating. I hope that you had a great time.
She's got the wave down.
She does. Look how cute. Good luck.
There are 11 Little Miss candidates.
Wow.
Now we have Great River Federal Credit Union. They're excited to join the Big Lake community with a new branch opening later this summer, right next to the Vet Hospital off of Highway 10. They're a full-service financial institution, constantly working on ways to innovate. Learn about becoming a member today by giving them a call or checking out their website at greatriverfcu.org.
And that looks like we have the Spooktacular Trail.
Pretty
by
spooky.
The Big Lake Women of Today. Big Lake Spooktacular is sponsored by the Big Lake Women of Today. It is a haunted trail that takes you through the woods on private land in Big Lake. This year it will be on Friday and Saturday, October 15th and 16th, and Friday and Saturday, October 22nd and 23rd from 7:30 to 10:30. The Kids Day and Family Day takes place on Saturday, October 22nd from noon to 3, and all proceeds go back into the community. For more information, contact them on their Facebook, Spooktacular Trail.
And right behind Spooktacular Trail, you can see one of the ghouls running past, Isabella Giroux. She is a Big Lake Little Miss Ambassador candidate.
Good luck, Isabella.
Looks like she is sponsored by the Knights of Columbus.
And then now we have the Hanover Harvest Festival Royalty. Hanover Princess Maddie Thompson joined them for their 16th annual Hanover Harvest Festival on Saturday, August 7th. And thank you, Hanover, for coming.
Right behind them doing a cheer is the Big Lake Youth Football Association. They're bringing football to kindergarten through sixth grade.
They sound tough and mean. Go Hornets.
All kinds of sporting opportunities out there. Something for everybody.
Yep. A lot of young people that love to get out there and get involved. And now we have the Big Lake Ambassador candidate, Adeline Goswich. She is sponsored by Getty Construction. Good luck, Adeline. Good parade wave she's got going there.
Got a side-by-side behind her.
Yep.
And here is Big Lake Ambassador candidate, Anna Scales. She's sponsored by the Big Lake Lions and Lioness Club. And they are riding in a 2012 Camaro convertible owned by Bob Quinn.
Behind her, we have STARS Dance Studio. STARS is your community dance studio, and they are celebrating 25 years of dance. Welcome, STARS. 25 years, that's a long time.
It is.
And the girls are performing. We'll watch them do their thing.
And they've been performing quite a bit. We're at the end of the parade route, so good for them. Right after STARS Dance Studio is Belle Plaine Barbecue Days Royalty. Today with the Belle Plaine Barbecue Days Royalty is Miss Belle Plaine Cadence Brandolin, First Princess Jalen Borison,
Second Princess Lydia Struford, and Miss Congeniality Bryn Meyer.
Nice looking float, lots of pretty flowers. Okay, and now we have the St. Francis Ambassadors. Development of young women in St. Francis through excellence, scholarship and achievement, and self-confidence and community involvement.
They're jamming out to some tunes.
They are.
The Pioneer Days in the Park.
Looks like we have Little Miss Adriana Glass. Marilyn Hollenbeck is a St. Francis Ambassador. And Little Miss Ambassador Lily Stryker.
Next, we have Big Lake Ambassador candidate Aspen Erickson. Big Lake Senior Ambassador candidate Aspen Erickson was born and raised in Big Lake. She aspires to change the lives of as many people and animals as she can to make a real difference. In her spare time, she volunteers at both the Big Lake Community Food Shelf and Happy Trails, which I believe is an animal shelter.
All right. Next up, we have the Big Lake Early Childhood. Their goals for each early childhood student is to be kind, be safe, be a learner in Big Lake's ECFE. Little Learners and Hive Time programs. Oh, look at that cute float. It looks like a big round bale of hay made out to look like a beehive.
Yeah, they posted a picture on Facebook this morning, and it is the cutest thing.
That is super cute.
Very inventive.
Yes. I know there's a lot of good things that are said about our Big Lake ECFE program. They have a lot of dedicated staff that really works hard to provide great opportunities for our little learners, get them started and off on the right foot.
They're holding a banner that has ECFE in the park advertised on it, which is a fabulous program that really showcases all of the beautiful parks here in Big Lake. They
and
travel
you
around.
And you help put that together with them, too.
Yeah, there's a coalition that all gets together, some volunteers, some staff, liaisons from the city, and it's just a great program. I encourage everyone to check that out.
Yeah, it's nice to see. They post a lot of stuff on their Facebook page, and a lot of parks that people don't even know are here, they get to be exposed to, so that is really cool.
There's Alan Berg walking back there. He puts a lot of time and effort into the community education in Big Lake.
Yes, they do.
We thank him for all of his efforts to provide opportunities to all ages of youth.
So we are very fortunate to have a lot of great people that invest so much time. Next we have Coburn's Marketplace of Big Lake. They got their Coburn's truck. You can get your food delivered.
They don't have the shopping cart with, but you know, with this truck, they do have opportunities for you to pick up without even having to go inside, order things online. And then the Maple Lake Royalty Program is coming up. Celebrate with Maple Lake Royalty on the second weekend in March for St. Patrick's Day every year.
Always fun when different royalty comes from the different communities around. Like I said, these girls, they call what develops with all the different programs the Sparkle Family. Now we have the Foley Ambassadors, the 2021 Foley Ambassadors, Abby and Callie, Junior Ambassadors, Elena and Olivia, and Little Miss Foley's Rose and Allison. They invite you to Foley Fun Days 2022, the third week in June. And all these young ladies will be going to the Big Lake Ambassador Coronation Program following the parade as well.
They call it the sparkle section.
Yep.
As you can see by their crowns, it is quite sparkly. And this is always a fan favorite.
Yes.
The Ballet Folklorico Rosa Kitsal dance team. The sounds of mariachi music, rhythmic flutter of their feet. Enjoy and dance along.
It's always fun to watch. They have such brilliant, colorful costumes. They come every year to
gorgeous dresses.
Yes. Now we have Little Miss Big Lake Ambassador Candidate Chloe Miller. She is sponsored by the Ice Country Fish House of Big Lake. That's a new one.
It is.
Yeah. They must do ice houses, I'm assuming.
We have plenty of lakes for it. Mm-hmm. It's like right behind her is this Senator Mary Kiffmeyer and Representative Paul Novotny of the Senate District 30 Republicans.
They said they got a lot of volunteers with them, too. This is a new vehicle. See, they got their signs, also Congressman Emmer, and they support law and order. Hey, we have Thielen Mechanical. Happy Homes. They pride themselves on providing the best service to their customers and their families. Thielen Mechanical.
It's like plumbing, heating, cooling.
So they got a new AC air conditioner that needs a lot of use this summer so far.
Absolutely. We Looks like the defeat of Jesse James Northfield Royalty. They invite you to the weekend after Labor Day to witness for yourself the guns blazing and failed robbery attempt by the James Younger Gang, along with a lot of other great activities. It includes a rodeo, three arts and crafts fairs, car shows, carnival, soapbox derby, and a parade. Something for everyone. It's the largest all-volunteer celebration in Minnesota.
Now we have the Big Lake Little Miss Ambassador candidate, Kylie Johnson. She is sponsored by the Cradle Club Child Care Center with locations in Edina, downtown Minneapolis, and Maple Grove.
And here is Evolution Taekwondo coming up. They strive to provide for the whole person, physical fitness, mental well-being, and an overall quality of life through the art of Taekwondo. They believe in teaching students fellowship and working together as a team for the great good of the community. They attend a lot of events and do some really cool demos at those events.
Yep.
Looks like they might be doing one right now.
I'm going to show you how to break a board. See, we have some form of martial arts skill there.
They have a sign saying they're now accepting new students as well, so make sure to give them a call and check out their website if you're interested in joining.
Now we have Big Lake Little Miss Ambassador candidate Ruby Berthune. She has lived in Big Lake for 11 years. She'll be entering sixth grade this fall. She loves to play basketball and go camping. Ruby is sponsored by Hiawatha Rubber Company, McKean Sports Bar, and Lanes and Sand Dune Spirits.
Here we
Good
have Rivers, River City Rhythm coming up. You can hear them before you see them. They're from Anoka, Minnesota. They're excited to be back on the streets, bringing their unique ability to entertain the crowds of summer.
We'll let them do their thing now.
They've won championships at the state and national level.
Five people. They do a great job. They make a lot of noise.
They sure do. Always a crowd favorite. You can see them.
Yep. Now we have GNM Outdoor Services LLC. They're one of the fastest growing and most trusted residential and commercial outdoor service teams serving the greater Monticello and Big Lake area. They offer a comprehensive selection of services, including landscaping, excavating, demolition, and snow removal. Visit their website at www.gmoutdoorservices.com.
Looks like they're now hiring as well.
It's a pretty big excavator, too. That must be a fun thing to dig in the dirt with.
They brought along their candy. They haven't run out yet, either.
That's good to see. That's what the kids are all here for.
Exactly. We have the Rockford Ambassadors coming up. On August 13th to the 15th, they host their Rockford River Days. Here today is Senior Ambassadors Kylie, Keeley, and Annika, and Junior Ambassadors Mary and Ashlyn.
It looks like a very pretty float. I wonder how they transport that from place to place. They must have to put it together when they get to each parade. So we want to welcome to make sure you all know this is our 49th year of Spudfest. We did not have a Spudfest parade last year, of course, because of COVID. So we're all happy to be back, and it is shown by the numbers of people that are out just wanting to have a good time and enjoy Spudfest. Next year we'll be planning and getting ready to celebrate our 50th year. We're looking to do some special things to acknowledge that.
keep in mind that there's always opportunities to volunteer, whether it's sitting on the board and helping with the planning, helping with volunteering at the parade today, at the festival itself, pouring beer.
Yeah, pretty much everybody that is involved in Spudfest volunteers and donates their time to make it happen. We as the board, of course, plan pretty much the whole year. We'll get done with this Spudfest parade and we'll review everything, make notes, and pretty much take maybe a break for a month or so and then start planning the next Spudfest parade and the festival. So it's just a continuous process, always looking to make the activities and the parade bigger and better for the community to enjoy. And we are fortunate to have such great support from a lot of our different groups and organizations that do step up to volunteer their time to help. Without them, this would not happen.
And thank you to all of the sponsors as well. All of the proceeds from this festival do get poured right back into the community.
Yes, we are. Our mission is to definitely support the youth of our community. So we do a lot of giving donations to various different organizations. Okay, next up is the St. Paul Bouncing Team. They're a nonprofit organization, and they're celebrating their 135th year of performing aerial acrobatics, that's a good word, at public and private social events. Beginning as a St. Paul Winter Carnival tradition, the team has made appearances at thousands of parades, fundraisers, and festivals across the state and the country. Join in with the familiar chant of one, two,
up she up goes.
She. Is that what it is?
Up she goes, yeah.
Ah. So that must be why it's taken a little bit of time. They probably stop and do that performance, and that definitely creates that spacing that
absolutely
we were working on filling.
And it sounds like they will also be at Luplin after the parade.
Oh, fun. Are they going to think that we do some performing there, too?
Absolutely.
Oh, they want the crowd to get involved.
Here comes that chant. Up she goes.
Wow, do you have to trust the people that are going to catch you? Great.
Absolutely.
Job. Thank you. And here again, this is a volunteer organization that does this, so that is super cool.
She's over 60 years old.
Wow. And if you didn't hear that, they just told us that the woman in the air is over 60 years old.
Good for her. That's amazing.
She must have quite a bit of practice
yes.
under her belt.
Now we have the Buffalo Days royalty. The city of Buffalo is known as the beautiful city by the lake. They have walking paths, area lakes, paddle boat, and canoe rentals, antique shops, and a park band show. The Buffalo Royalty remind everyone to share the gift of your smile with people you meet. And they invite you to come out to enjoy Buffalo. It looks like we have Buffalo Days. They're always in June. So they've already had it, 13th through the 20th.
Behind the Buffalo Days royalty, coming up here, we have a beautiful vehicle. It's like a Nova Custom. And then we have Big Lake Little Miss Ambassador candidate Savannah Nelson. She's being driven by Dave Nelson Greenhouse and Vegetable Farm.
They have a lot of girls out, too, for the Big Lake Ambassador program this year. Next up, we have Riley Nelson. Riley is a Big Lake Junior Ambassador candidate, and she is
She's also being driven by Dave Nelson Greenhouse and Vegetable Farm.
That's what confused me for a second.
Yeah, Riley and Savannah are actually sisters.
Okay.
Well, and Riley was a little miss a handful of years ago as well, so
good luck, ladies. Right now we have the Sherburne County Fair. That takes place from July 15th through the 18th. July 15th is Daycare Day. July 16th features the Jared Neiman and 2 Mile Final Concert. And July 17th features the Sherburne County Fair Parade.
We have the Big Lake Ambassador candidate, Chloe Olson. She's sponsored by Big Lake Beyond the Yellow Ribbon, and she's a student at Independence Elementary. She's enjoyed making friends, selling buttons, and meeting Miss Minnesota during her candidacy.
Now we have the Big Lake Gymnastics 2021 state competition competitors and 2020 state champs. Yeah, the Big Lake Gymnastics program is a very long-standing program at the schools. They do a great job. These young ladies are amazing at what they can do.
It's like they're doing some tumbling for the crowd.
Walking on their hands. Well, she could probably, that young one there in the center, that was a long walk. Good for her.
A lot of talent there.
And to have that confidence that you can do this on a street, too. No mats. Good job, ladies.
And not just talent, but a lot of practice, skill.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
It's like now we have Peterson Towing and Recovery. Oh, it looks like they must not have made it out today. It's actually Big Lake Youth Wrestling, the Youth Athletic Association. They are for preschool through middle school ages. You can register your kids this October. Quote by Dan Gabel is, once you've wrestled, everything else in life is easy.
Great sport, too, to get involved with. I know a lot of families that get
involved. Girls wrestle,
with
too, as, yep. as her sign says.
Yep, and they do. That's cool to see. And here, and they've also provided the, they're in charge of keeping the grounds clean, emptying those garbage cans, and so we appreciate all their efforts over this Bugfest weekend. Now we have Paul Kinnear, the mayor of Big Lake. Paul was first elected to city council in 2018 and was elected to the mayoral seat in November of 2020. He brought his wife Julie and some of his family with him. Thank you, Paul, for your service to the community. And one thing I got to say about Paul, his memory is amazing. There he is waving at us. Hi, Paul.
We have the Refuge and Evangelical Free Church. They meet in Zimmerman. They have weekly services and activities for all ages throughout the year, as well as vacation Bible school in the summer. You can visit their website at refugefc.org.
It's good to see y'all. Here next up we have Big Lake Ambassador candidate Emily Lemire. Big Lake Ambassador senior candidate Emily Lemire. Emily's sponsors are State Farm, Trails Bar and Grill, and Bob's Towing. And good luck, Emily. She's got her parade wave down too. These ladies are so lucky today. It's so beautiful. It's not hot. Nice breeze, and they're not getting beaten down, beaten with sun.
Absolutely.
And it can, you know, really, how that can be.
really get warm when you're wearing a long gown like that.
Yes. So we're grateful Mother Nature is cooperating.
Blowing kisses to the crowd.
Yeah.
Love to see it, Emily.
She's having a good time. That's great to see.
And now it looks like we have a brief break again. So the menu for today, we have the Casey's. They are the sponsors of our food tent. So you can find them along with their helpers. They're serving spuds. You can have your spud done and add whatever you want. It can be a taco meat. It can be a vegetable, just lots of cheese and sour cream. However you want it done, they can get that spud doctored up for you. Also, they're grilling a lot of good hot dogs and hamburgers, and they're doing it the old-fashioned way, charcoal style.
Absolutely.
I was here earlier and seen them getting the grill all lit up, and with that smell that you don't smell as often as you used to, with the lighter fluid and getting that charcoal started. So,
and if that doesn't tickle your fancy, the carnival also has all of the traditional fair food, from cheese curds to funnel cakes.
Yep.
Lupulin, Spudfest beer is on tap, as well as a variety of other Coors products.
Yep. And what do we have coming down the road?
Looks like Four Corners Real Estate, Keller Williams Integrity.
They looks like they provide services unique to the needs of first-time to forever home buyers, along with Spanish-speaking services.
It's very important.
Yes. I'm amazed. It looks like everybody has. Usually what happens on this end of the route is a lot of the organizations have run out of candy by now. So it's good to see that that doesn't appear to be the case. So we're
Absolutely.
Fortunate.
Looks like they're spotlighting us over there.
It looks like we have a Dr. Seuss hat coming at us.
Could you, would you sell a house?
Yeah, look at how cute that is. I don't know, in the market nowadays, you might be able to sell it really fast. I'm not sure if you'd be able to buy one to move into, though. That would be the challenge.
Here we have Spud Inc. with Big Lake Robotics. Spud Inc. 6709 is Big Lake's first robotics team, which has designed and built a candy delivering robot for today's parade. To see their competition robot in action, you can visit their booth in front of the middle school building during all of Spudfest, specifically this Saturday afternoon.
And when they first formed and came and said they were going to call themselves the Spud Inc., we loved that name.
Absolutely.
Well, good question. We just had asked how many potato farms are in Big Lake. So right now, I think we probably have about four. We've got Wingard. We've got,
quite a few.
Yeah. There's probably about four. For some reason, I'm having this mind blank. Good question.
We've got our cable commission asking us some questions about potatoes, and I don't know if we have the answers.
I don't know if we
How
have
many
the
potatoes are gone through
I'm
at the festival?
At least 500.
Quite a few.
I'm going to go with 500.
The Knights of Columbus at that food tent really serve up the potatoes all weekend long. You can also find some of the smaller farmers at our Big Lake Farmers Market selling local potatoes as well. They may not produce them in as large a quantities as those other four farmers, but it's a great way to support the local little farmers every Wednesday at Lakeside Park.
Yeah, we have Wingard's, Sanford's. I'm going to keep thinking about this.
All right. Here we have Big Lake Ambassador candidate Miranda Jelinek. She is a senior candidate being driven by Stephen Orcutt in a Shelby 2008 Mustang. She is sponsored by the Third Rail Bar and Grill, located right here in Big Lake.
Good luck, Miranda. I'm always thankful that these girls will do this. Next up, we have The Big Lake Bass Team. Big Lake Bass Team provides opportunities to fish, learn, and grow as an angler and a young adult. Their coaching philosophy is to develop everyone from novice to more experienced fishermen. And this includes the students, coaches, and boat captains. And this is just, I think, starting for the last couple of years. They're getting off the ground, and it's great to see. You cannot be called Big Lake and not have a fishing team for your school.
Agreed. Absolutely agreed. And there's a lot of bass teams in the surrounding area that even come to Big Lake to take advantage of our beautiful lakes, is really, really cool to see.
I don't know if many people know it, but Big Lake is known as a bass lake for bass fishermen. And I just don't think a lot of people realize that.
Absolutely.
Look at the size of some of the motors on those boats. They're serious. It's good to see the amount of young people out to do it. We have fishermen and fisherwomen.
Beautiful boats out here.
Now it looks like we have a gap again after this last boat. I'm still thinking on... We have Duchesne's potato farm. I'm still thinking of the potato farms, people. I would hate. Baked potatoes. Put all the toppings on them that you would like to do. Also, you would think that we would have French fries, but I don't think there are any French fries this year.
There are some tachos available.
Yep, you're right. Yeah, tachos, which
is... Here they are spotlighting us again.
Yeah, this is the most that we've been on camera for
I think any year that we've done this.
Yes, I agree.
And they're putting us on the spot with these potato questions, I'm telling you. Ooh, our favorite potato topping. What a question. I'm a dairy lover. I don't know if it would be cheese or sour cream, but one of the two.
I'm a fan of putting on the cheese, the sour cream, and the butter. Yeah,
that's maybe that's, some chives on there as well.
Yep. I don't think there's much that I don't mind on my potato.
Agreed. That's the thing about potatoes. They're so versatile. You can do a lot with them.
Yep. And I don't know if people know that a lot of the potatoes that are down served at the state fair come from locally grown potato farmers in our area. And I don't think a lot of people know that.
That's a huge, huge opportunity for them, the amount of people that go to the state fair.
Yep. So we are known for spuds.
Looks like here we have the Big Lake Troop 93 Boy Scouts. They are collecting cans to help pay for a high adventure camp out. Consider donating your aluminum cans to their cause.
Yes, and you can find their cans up at Coburn's parking lot. They've got a nice cage facility up there. So recycle by giving your cans and donating them to the Boy Scouts.
And keep in mind to not throw them in bags into the container, not to put any trash or other recyclable products.
Plus, I see that they brought one of their cages with them.
Great example of how you can get rid of those cans.
I think it's cool, too, if you see in the back, they've got it boarded up, but normally you put your bag through that little opening and then you toss all your cans in there. Thank you, Boy Scouts, for doing that recycling. Next up, we have the Big Lake Cheerleading. Big Lake Cheerleading is led by coaches Derek and Kayleen Nelson. This is their six-year coaching. Last season, the varsity competition and varsity game day teams competed nationally, earning third and seventh place, respectively. In the parade are some of the program cheerleaders, along with the Little Hornets, first through fifth grade youth.
I believe they attended a camp recently.
Oh, fun.
And this is so exciting to see. When I was in high school quite some time ago, our cheerleading program was very small, and they've brought this to a whole nother level. The support and the number of people involved, girls and boys, is exciting to see.
Yes, both of both Derek and Kayleen have done an excellent job. And it's not only the cheerleading aspect, but they really, really support and get the girls involved in, and boys involved in volunteering activities in their community as well. And they have been very helpful at the food booth with the KCs, helping them through the weekend with getting the food sold to the customers. So. And there is not much that the Derek and his team will not help with. You just have to ask.
So you name it, and they're there.
Yep, yep. They're definitely a family.
Oh, this is a cheer that we did.
Ooh, here we have our bee. Here's our hornet. This is our
mascot.
Look
at the muscles on that hornet. And the bow.
This bee means business.
Sure does.
That's a one tough bee.
I believe some of these ambassadors here are also in the cheerleading program.
Yep. Wanted to give the bee a hug, for sure. All right, next up we have Big Lake Little Miss Ambassador candidate Quinn Grove. Big Lake Little Miss Ambassador candidate Quinn is sponsored by Russell's on the Lake. Good luck, Quinn.
Now we have Groom My Friend, which is a local grooming salon here in Big Lake.
They just opened up, too, and I've heard they're doing great business. If you want your animal to get a spa day and get treated well, definitely take them to Groom My Friend.
I believe Bruno's paid a visit there.
Yes, Bruno got all gussied up for the parade. Now we have Cargill Protein. Patties in one shipment. Cargill Protein in Big Lake is growing with exciting career opportunities. Join their team today. They're a great company to work for. Thank you, Cargill, for being a part of our community.
And they've provided some expansions of their facilities. They offer a lot of jobs to residents here in the community.
Yep. Great company to work for.
Oh, there's the chicken.
Gotta love it, don't you?
Somebody's got to lay all those eggs.
I don't know if a lot of people know, but I think the egg patties that I think McDonald's uses comes from a Cargill.
Yeah, I think business. Some of the school systems, too.
Yep, yep.
The Patriot newspaper is up next. They deliver a newspaper in your mailbox every Saturday, bringing you school events, local government news, sports, and much more. This free distribution newspaper is possible because of advertising. They ask that you continue to support them as well as all the local businesses that make this paper possible.
Yes, we didn't have a paper for a little bit, and we're glad they're here. Okay, next up we have Olivia Holman. She's a Big Lake Little Miss Ambassador candidate, and she is sponsored by Just Say Yes by Alyssa Johnson, who is an independent stylist at Hair Obsession Salon. And it looks like she had her hair all done up. Super cute today. I bet your sponsor did it.
I'm sure. She did a great job.
Good luck,
Olivia.
Here we
have the Great River Soccer Club, which is a home for both Big Lake, Monticello, as well as Becker and the surrounding communities.
That's one big soccer ball, too. Soccer is a very popular sport in the area.
They got the soccer net and everything.
Yep. Now we have the St. Michael Royalty. St. Michael, they're excited to be back and celebrate another awesome year at Spudfest. Join them the second weekend in August for the St. Michael Days and Nights Festival. Thank you for coming.
Now we have Big Lake Junior Ambassador candidate, Amaro Bia. She is sponsored by Riverwood Bank. Riverwood Bank has two local branches in Minnesota, proudly serving us on both sides of the river.
Good luck, Amara. Now we have the Princeton Ambassadors, the City of Flowers. We have Princeton Ambassadors Kaya and Kayla, Junior Ambassadors Shelby and Kelsey, and Little Princeton, Avery, and Amelia. I'm assuming that's princesses. Thank you, ladies, for coming. Cute float, too. Have Watertown royalty? Is that who this is? Not quite sure on this one. This one looks like it's a sneak in on us. Not quite sure. It says the Hamden Fire Department.
Wondering if maybe this
Never
is
forget.
Keith Hansen? Oh, it sure is.
Which one is it?
This is Keith Hansen. He is the father of a fellow 2009-2010 Big Lake Ambassador, Sarah Hansen.
Oh, okay. Now we have CentraCare. CentraCare has grown to meet the health needs of our communities and is now one of our largest health systems in Minnesota. This means they are able to offer the latest advancements in care, technology, and treatments close to home. CentraCare is here for you. We are lucky to have a good hospital facility.
Now we have the Howard Lake Good Neighbor Days. Like we have Ambassador Rebecca, Destiny, Madison, and Haley.
Now we have Kinexus Energy. Kinexus Energy, your most powerful membership electric company. And they do a good job of servicing the community. I have Kinexus Energy, so I can say that I very seldom have my power go out. And if it does, it's usually because of a storm. And they're there to get that taken care of quick as can be.
Here we have Elite Transportation. Be sure to give them a call for all of your transportation needs at 763-785-0124. You can also visit EliteTransportationSYS.com. They've been in business for over 20 years. Got the big old purple truck coming through.
I did. I seen them come down Gulf Street. Now we have the Becker Big Lake Youth Hockey Association, where the area's youth go to start their hockey career. Program options are available for boys and girls starting at the age of 3 all the way through to high school. Hello. This is a combined effort between Becker and Big Lake, so it's good to see both communities coming together to provide this opportunity for our youth and want to be involved in hockey. They've been working diligently on working to get a arena.
And we have a few that might have snuck in. Here we have Majestic Creations. They do some wonderful printing.
Yes, they do.
Located right between Big Lake and Becker. There's Bobby in her beautiful Jeep. You
that
can see
one
her driving around town.
Jeep.
It sure is.
Yeah, it looks like we're going to have a few more that we're not. You see what that says? Something exquisite.
It's like some visiting royalty. Miss Global United Lifetime Queen, Danielle. Beautiful crowns.
They are pretty, aren't they? We're going to roll with this here at the end, so bear with us. Thank you for coming, ladies. I know, we were just saying how gorgeous they are.
Beautiful crowns. Very unique. A lot of the ambassadors we've seen have more of a silver.
Yep. Yeah, these got some gold and some silver. I even think I see some, a little bit of turquoise green.
I'll tell you, those are not easy to put on, especially the large one in the front with her.
You think they're heavy to wear?
That very large crown, oh my goodness. It'll put dents in your head, actually.
Oh, wow.
Back in the day, we used to put a penny underneath the crown
just to
stop that
from
happening,
that.
Yeah.
And here it looks like we have Montrose Junior Ambassador Macy Gahan, and it looks like she is being sponsored by Ryan Chevrolet. Here's Peterson's Towing. They were earlier in the parade, but it looks like they ended up kind of coming in at the end. This is Peterson's Towing Recovery, another towing operation that serves the Big Lake community.
And then we have Berta's Towing back here. They serve Rogers, Monticello, Albertville, Loretto, and it looks like a lot of communities outside of that as well.
Yep. I don't think we're lacking for any towing needs. We're well served in the community.
A lot of great services in the area.
Yep. And this looks like we're wrapping up the end of the 2021 49 Annual Spudfest Parade. We want to thank everybody for coming out and enjoying the day with us and looking forward to seeing you next year for our 50th celebration in 2022. And usually we're used to seeing the Bud Mitchell tractors come out that usually bring up the end of our parade, but it looks like the family wasn't able to make it with any of the tractors today.
It's a big process, and we've had kind of a gap year, so
yep.
We're just happy to have everyone that came out today that was available.
Yes, thank you so much, and that will bring to a close our 2021 49th Annual Spudfest Parade. Thank you, Corey, for joining me.
And thank you, Rayanne. We'll see you at the festival.
Bye.